Were you aware that the average person uses 70 gallons of domestic drinking water per day? We use it from everything from cooking, cleaning, taking a shower, and flushing the toilet. So really, clean drinking water is the foundation of modern society. That's only half the story. Hi, I'm Dan DRISCOLL. I'm the superintendent for the wastewater division here in the city of Concord. And if you live here in Concord or work here in Concord, chances are the water that goes down the drain comes here. Here is the wastewater treatment plant at Hall Street here in Concord. The Hall Street wastewater treatment plant was designed to treat 10.1 million gallons a day of domestic wastewater. So this plant was built in 1982 and has been running 24 hours a day ever since. That's 40 years of continuous operation. Much of the equipment you'll see today has been in service for that long. Currently, this wastewater treatment plant treats approximately 3 million gallons a day. To put that in perspective, that's approximately 5 Olympic-sized swimming pools. So my staff and I are excited to show you around to see what it takes to clean up the city's wastewater.
Hi, my name is David Weber. I'm the Operations Supervisor for the City of Concord's Wastewater Division. Today we'll be giving you a tour of the Hall Street Wastewater Treatment Facility. And we'll start at our influent building, which is where the raw sewage comes in from the City of Concord. And then it works its way down through a couple large holding tanks known as primary clarifiers. So from the primary clarifiers, it goes to our intermediate pump station, where it's pumped to the top of our biocell filter, which from there it goes into our aeration tanks, where the wastewater is aerated and the microbes perform most of our treatment. From there goes our secondary clarifiers, where the sludge settles to the bottom and our clear effluent water is on top. From the secondary clarifiers, it goes to our chlorine building, where it's disinfected with sodium hypochlorite and eventually goes to the Merrimack River.
I'm Zach. I work here at the Hall Street Wastewater Facility as an operator. And here we have the beginning of the plant, where all the water from the City of Concord comes through and starts their process. Below we have the wet well, which is 35 feet deep from the top of these covers. And behind me we have the three screw pumps that take the water out of the wet well and boost it up to the influent building, where we start screening. So over here we have the top of the screw pumps, where all the water is being brought to from down in the wet well. Below my feet is where the water is being dropped out. From there, it moves into the screening conveyor right here, which what is happening is it's taking all the big debris out from the water before it goes into the next section of the cycle. So after everything gets caught in the screens, the water comes over here to the grit collection system. And basically what this does is it collects anything like rocks or sand, inorganic material. So after the grit collection system, our water goes here into the primary clarifier, where the primary sludge is settled out, and the water goes into the bio tower behind me over there.
Hi, my name is Dean COSTELLO. I am a wastewater operator for the City of Concord here at Hall Street and a smaller plant up in Penacook. From the primary clarifier, the water makes its way to the intermediate pump station. And in this station, we have pumps that could pump about 17 million gallons a day. And part of that flow is recirculated through our bio tower. So after the intermediate pump station and recirculation through the bio tower, the water flows into one of these two tanks. This is aeration tank A and B. We have blowers here that pump air through piping and then through diffusers to aerate this basin. Now what the diffusers do is they help distribute the airflow coming out of the, I guess you could say, the air exit location. These tanks are aerated to encourage microbial feeding of the bugs or microorganisms that do inhabit this tank for treatment purposes. After the water flows through the aeration basin, it then comes to our secondary clarifiers. The purpose of our secondary clarifiers is to settle out the remaining solids after the aeration basin. After the solids settle out, the remaining water then overflows the weirs and heads to our chlorine building for disinfection. After the solids settle out in the secondary clarifier, the water then flows to the chlorine building. In this building, we chlorinate the water for treatment. That water goes through a serpentine-like tank, and then after it flows through the tank, the water is then dechlorinated and discharged into the Merrimack River. In the chlorine building is the final step of our process. In the chlorine building, we have here one of three odor control units in the Hall Street Wastewater facility. This unit specifically cleans the air from our sludge holding tank.
Hi, my name is Dylan. I'm an operator here at the City of Concord Wastewater Treatment Facility. Today I'm going to talk to you about our sludge dewatering process. Raw influent comes into the building and goes through a screening process. Afterward, it flows into a big tank we call a primary clarifier. Solids in the clarifier settle to the bottom. This is what we call sludge. Sludge is pumped from the bottom of the clarifier into a holding tank where it's then aerated and mixed. When the tank is full and we're ready to dewater sludge, we pump the sludge up to these machines we call belt presses. Polymer is added to the sludge to thicken it, which helps in the dewatering process. While sludge is on the belt presses, it's compressed between two belts, which ride over a series of rollers. This squeezes water out of the sludge, and this is our dewatering process. Our dewatered sludge is what we call cake. Cake is scraped off of the belts into a conveyor system, which transfers the sludge into a trailer. When the trailer is full, a company comes to haul away the product for composting.
Hi, I'm Kristin, Noel. I run the lab here, and we make sure that we do all the analysis and that we're meeting all the EPA standards.
Thank you for visiting the Concord Wastewater Treatment Facility today. For more information, please visit us on the web at concordnh.gov. Thank you.